I want to talk to you about the first step in delivering transformational change through data. And that first step is by creating a data strategy. So interestingly, data strategy isn't just about data. Now you might think of things like data management and data governance and moving data around, which are really important components, but actually a data strategy for us is about a framework that allows you to generate business value through the application of data and analytics. And that covers a whole bunch of things across an organization. And we want to talk to you about six key pillars that make up the foundational building blocks of a solid data strategy. Now, first up is vision and value. Now, the vision and value pillar of the data strategy is all about aligning your data initiatives and programs and work and efforts around a business outcome that aligns itself to the business strategy. Now, next up is all about people and skills. And regardless of the size of your organization, there are a set of capabilities that are needed in order to technically sort the data and from a business perspective, get the most value out of it and ensure that you drive business change. Now, here we need to think about who is going to take ultimate responsibility for the data strategy within your organization. Lots of people are opting for a chief data officer in this space. And that chief data officer needs to put a team made up of business engagement, solution delivery, and governance to ensure that you can maximize those opportunities that you want to go after. Now, the third pillar is all about how you organize those people and skills in the right way that will maximize those opportunities that you're trying to go after. And this is about, do you put those people centrally in one team? Do you distribute those people across your organization? Or do you have some sort of hybrid where you have central capabilities and best practices, but local subject matter expertise? In this pillar, we also need to think about the operating model. And this is how you will work. This is the methodologies that you will use. This is the thinking that needs to go into how you will operate in order to be agile, responsive, proactive, and iterative and innovative with your data efforts. Now, the fourth pillar, we finally get to talk about data, and this is data governance. So data governance for us is all about how do you drive trust in the data, in the numbers, in the insight, in the output that algorithms give so that people believe in what they're looking at and believe what they're seeing. The fifth pillar is about technology and architecture. Now, technology is about choosing the right tools, and architecture is about designing how you knit those tools together and the architecture that you put in the applications that you build in those technologies. We need to think about how you get data into your organization. We need to think about how you manage and govern and look after that data. We need to think about how you visualize and get insight from that data. We need to think about how you build models, algorithms, machine learning engines that deliver real high value outputs for you. And we need to think about how do we provision and push that data potentially to other systems, to other companies, to other parts of the business so that they can receive that data and do something with it in their own right. Now, the final pillar is the roadmap. And the roadmap is about laying out a plan for all the other pillars that we've talked about in a time horizon so that we have a framework that we can manage, facilitate, and communicate how we're going to make all of this business change. This in its own right becomes a really fundamental tool to help explain to the organization and help you judge yourself and test yourself and score yourself about how you're performing in terms of implementing and executing your data strategy. So that's it, the six pillars of a good data strategy that provides you with a framework that helps you articulate how you'll deliver business value through the application of data and analytics. Hope you found it useful.